Hello everyone, T1 here, and today I'd like to share this storage, which is, I think, is the way Mojang intended storage to be. So to demonstrate, I'm gonna pull all these items to create calls. Those calls can be stored in those shift register lines. There's a little bit too much memory here. I don't think anyone will ever need to use that much, but I just had the space and I just made it that way. The slowest processing is a counter here that creates a box that correlating to the code of that specific slice. But it's about 25 seconds for a call, so I figure out it's a bit slow, but it's fast enough to me. So, and by the way, calls that are secondary, so if the same line has way more than one call, those are processed way faster, maybe even more than half of the time, because the counter will pre-count those boxes to generate the correlated code way in advance. So once the system is ready to accept the next call, that call can go right through. Right, next, I guess I will show block. So block is totally decentralized. Why? Why not? And also because it will let you only load a small area versus a big area of your whole bulk storage. Let's say you only need to get carrots, and carrots are stored right here, so you will not order it from a huge bulk system of a billion plus items. You're only gonna be loading this small area, and this small area will give you the carrots that you need without loading every part of the system. Now if you order more for more areas, you will obviously load the correlated areas. The way this bulk works is it has two inputs, one for calls, and it's really basic. It's a box comes with a call, the box creates a call, that call gets generated and it gets sent to the correct end gates, to the correct location. Kind of looks complex, but in reality it's actually very simple. Now what also happens is it has another portal here. That portal will send, it will do two things. It will send a box with a call, so let's say this is a one. That one will open the correlated slice for input. And that same, what the hell is going on? I send it an empty box. I gotta pick this and throw a box. So now that box has a one in it. That one gets processed, sends it in, and once that one is open, that same portal will actually teleport the items right here, and those items will go exactly to the correct place, and then close everything, and yeah. Everything is really nice. So as you can see, this is just got disengaged. So that piston moves this ice here, and the way portals work is they're working with a certain grid, and now because that ice is here and this ice is higher than the ice here, this portal will send all its items here. So yeah, so one portal does two things. This portal just does one thing, just calls, and this is open the slice for the call, for the input, and it's actually sending the boxes to go to the correlated slice. So yeah, very compact, and this is kind of disabled here now, but this is the chunk loading system to so once an order comes in or something happening, this will engage that and those chunks will be loaded. This is a 1.12 loading grid for this bulk system. And yeah, so why is it the way Mojang intended, because you will have to use overloaded comparators, you will have to do falling block technology, and in this case you will have to generate the world in 3.19 versions and do some other cool stuff on the way if you wish so. And yeah, that gives you pretty much, so this end is generated at 3.19, so you don't have any islands, so it extends the easy to manipulate end gateway grid, and this is basically it. Thank you for watching.